Hi, this is Ron Deering coming to you from my home office in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. And today I'm going to share with you seven easy tweaks that will help you attract red hot leads to your blog. So stay tuned. All right, great. Welcome back. Okay, we're going to start with seven easy tweaks that will attract more red hot leads through your blog. I was on a webinar the other day and it was great. I think it was last night and they talked about actually 11 or 12 of them. And I thought these were the top seven that I know have worked great for me. So I want to share those with you. All right, first one is a very distinct homepage opt-in. What you're looking at here is my homepage, and you can see if we scroll up here a little bit, I've got a video talking about what I do, and I also have on the right over here is the opt-in. Now, I've chosen to go to a two-step opt-in. A lot of people still have a one-step where you can input their name and their email right there on the opt-in box. I've chosen to go to a two-step, and what do I mean by two-step? If they click here, it takes them to another page, and now they can get more information, opt-in if they want to, and then when they click out of this, what's nice is, boom, they're right back on my page. So I think that's a great way to do things, and I've done that with most of my opt-ins now, is taking them to another page. I found higher conversion rates and so forth on that. Number two is a sidebar opt-in, and you'll see the sidebar opt-in is this guy right here, and again, it's set up so that when you click on it, it takes you to a new page, and then they can opt in from there, and when they're done, it takes them, they can close it out and come right back to your page. So that's just a great way to do things. The third one is PS lines in all of your blogs. So what do I mean by that? Well, let's go to one of my blogs here. And you'll notice down at the bottom, I have a signature area, but I also have this PS area right here. And I started doing that when I went through a course that Ray Higdon, my mentor and friend, put together a few months ago, 6 months or so ago, and it was just great. It's the 3-minute expert, and you can find that at rondeering.com/3ME. And here we go. This is, I think, the next one anyways. But and it's amazing how my leads have changed just by putting this simple PS line in the bottom of each of my posts, and it's basically real simple. If your upline does not have a step-by-step blueprint for online marketing success, check this out unless you already have too many leads. Okay, and then again, when they click on this, it takes them to another page, and they can opt in, and now I can capture their leads and start dripping on them. So that is number three. Number four is hyperlinking throughout your post, and there are two real types of hyperlinking, and I'm going to show you two. I don't have them actually in this one right here, but the first one is what we call direct hyperlink, and a direct hyperlink is when you put some text out that says click here, and then they click here. That's they directly are clicking where it says to click here, and that's a direct hyperlink. The other type of hyperlink is what you see on this page is, in the middle of some text, you key in on a key phrase or keyword, and here's kind of an example of a direct one. Here's a replay, click it, you know. But most of these are what we call indirect hyperlinks. And you don't want to overdo it, but you do want to have a number of them in there so people will click on them based on the phrase or the call to action of click here. So that's the hyperlinking throughout your post. This number five is pop-ups, and I'm going to refresh this and wait. I think I've got this one set at 20 seconds, but this is an ongoing debate. Some people say, oh, they're just too obnoxious, people hate them, and so forth. Well, what I have found is that the very small percentage of people that don't like them compared to the people that opt in very quickly outweighed having one. So this is a program I use, is called it's a WordPress pop-up, I think is the name of it, for the plugin, and you can see that. And here it is. After about 20-30 seconds, it pops up. And again, I don't collect any email or name information in this, but when they click here, it's going to take them to another page and we can get their information there. So, and you can control how long before it comes up, and you can see here, this one, it gives me the option, someone doesn't want to see it ever again, they can do that. So that is number five. Number six is page menus. And a lot of people don't do this and they don't understand, but I've got a couple of them here. One, this team with Ron, it goes to a new page that explains all about a system that I'm involved with that is designed to work with any network marketing company to build and gather leads. The other is this top menu up here called courses. And each one of these, again, takes them to a new page where I can collect their leads and they can get free products. Okay, so you're always giving out value. You're always giving them a way to give you their information for the exchange for that value and that benefit. And number seven is the Seth Godin plugin. And you've probably heard about this. If you haven't, he's a world famous publisher and so forth that talks about marketing, SEO, and so forth. But it's a great little plugin. And what it does is it allows you can see it right here. It allows you to put at the top or the bottom, I believe, a welcome message. And that welcome message can be based on whether or not they are a first-time visitor or a visitor that is returning. And again, same thing. Hey there, I know you. Welcome back. Go ahead and click here to start getting leads on autopilot today. You can make this any way you want. And again, this click, when they click on it, takes them to a new page where I can there get their information. They can opt in and we can start tracking and we can start dripping on them and giving them more value each and every day. Now, I wanted to throw in a couple of bonuses also. And one of those is I want to show you, and I didn't do it on these because they really didn't relate necessarily to where I wanted to go. But when you go to this image right here, you can see that it's clickable. If I click on it right now, it just gives me a larger view of that. But you can set that up, and I'm going to go in the back office here, and I'm going to go to this actual post. And this is actually a different post, but I'm going to go to an image, and I'm going to click on edit. And when you go into that edit, you see here where you can choose what it's linked to. And I just right now I've kept it linked to the media file, but you can put a custom URL in there. And if you've got images in your post that relate to something that you're marketing or some free video or free PDF audio or something that you want to give away, then you want to change this to a custom URL. And when they click on that image, it will take them again outside down here. You can say open in a new window, and that's what you want to do. It will take them to that new page, and you will be able to collect their lead information. And the last one is social media shares. This is bonus two. And this is kind of a no-brainer. You want people to share. You can see here I have a bar on the right, a vertical bar on the right, on the left, I'm sorry, you're on the right. And then I have a bar down here underneath where people can share. Now this one, pretty popular. It's not huge, but it's, you can see I've got shares on Google+, Pinterest, Twitter, and LinkedIn and that. But again, social media interaction, social media sharing gets it out to the people that share it and the people that they are connected with, which makes it become viral very quickly. So I hope this has given you some insights and some tweaks that will help your blogging experience. I am a huge fan of blogging. I will show you up here. I started in January and I was unknown. And as of today, you can see my Alexa score because of blogging and these tips and so forth. I'm 97,000th in the U.S. and almost in the 200,000th in the world. And that's in, what, 7-8 months of blogging. Part of that is being consistent, learning. I've taken a number of courses on blogging and how to tweak things and how to set things up. And I hope this has helped you and will get you to that point where you're getting more traffic and more leads every day, building your network marketing and changing your life.